our own religion sometimes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us more conscious of Him at all times. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that speaks about nikah. How nikah and why nikah? A person generally makes dua in the month of Ramadan. If they are married, Ya Allah, give me happiness in my marriage. Ya Allah, grant me children who will be the coolness of my eyes. Ya Allah, I've got children already. Make them pious, make them this, make them that. Grant me a long and healthy life and so on and so forth. But a person who's not married, Ya Allah, grant me a spouse who will be the coolness of my eyes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the doors for all those who are not married. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them spouses who will be the coolness of their eyes. But what is more important than nikah is the life after nikah. That is what is more important. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about nikah. And firstly, He says what type of a person you should marry. Marry those who are God conscious so that they will not oppress you in any way, male or female. And Allah says those who have no iman, those who are polytheists or polytheists, those who are polytheists, stay far away from them unless they are ready to accept Islam. Then they become equivalent to you and you can marry them thereafter. وَلَا تَنْكِحُ الْمُشْرِكَاتِ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنُ. Don't ever marry a person who associates, partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until they leave that and they accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the iman. Don't ever marry those. You know, today if I were to give you a simple example, and I've given this example in the past. If there is a person who is a vegetarian and another person who only eats seafood, he's on a seafood diet. If the two had to marry, would that marriage work? Well, someone might say, yes, it might work, but your food is absolutely different. This person cannot touch anything to do with vegetables. That person cannot touch anything to do with seafood. So after 1 year or 2 years, you'd get sick of each other. Doesn't it make common sense? It does. So if that is the case with people whose eating habits are different, completely different, what about those whose entire faith is different? Do you think that marriage can work? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to marry the Muslimin or to marry those who are ready to accept Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses both the male and the female and tells them, look, when you want to marry, make sure you know who you are marrying and why you are marrying. What is the reason? What are you looking at? What are the qualities you are looking at? May Allah make that easy for us. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that speaks about talaq. You know, normally we hardly hear about talaq because when we have a nikah function, it's wrong for the imam to start talking about talaq. If that particular marriage breaks, they will say, you know, we were cursed from day one when that imam spoke about talaq at our wedding, at our nikah. So for that reason, a lot of us do not know the rules about talaq. We need to learn them. We need to educate ourselves in that regard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you would like to divorce a woman, divorce her. If you are going to live with her correctly. If you are not going to live with her, release her in a good manner, but don't keep her hanging. وَلَا تُمْسِكُوهُنَّ ضِرَارًا لِتَعْتَدُوا. Don't keep them held, neither married nor unmarried, just because you want to punish them. No, that must never happen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says that whenever husband and wife would like to reconcile, nobody must come in their path. If they are reconciling for the correct reasons, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا طَلَّقْتُمُ النِّسَاءَ فَبَلَغْنَ أَجَلَهُنَّ فَلَا تَعْضُلُوهُنَّ أَن يَنْكِحْنَ أَزْوَاجَهُنَّ إِذَا تَرَاضَوْا بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. After you have divorced your wives, a revocable divorce, and that divorce which is one talaq has gone through and you have been separated, if still you want to get back, no one must stop you from getting back to your own spouse. Obviously a new nikah is required if the term of the iddah is over. And in these verses Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the terms of the iddah of both a woman who has been divorced and a woman who has been widowed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. Many people now feel that, you know what, that was an ancient ruling of a long time ago. Nowadays we don't need to sit in iddah. Wallahi, I tell you, that is haram thinking. That type of thinking is haram. Allah, who has created us, is the one who knows how we operate. It is like a person who says, I have a motor vehicle. I would like to turn right, but I'm going to turn the steering left because I know better what I'm doing. It's barbaric. to turn the steering right when you want to turn right. I'd rather turn it left and I know I will turn right. That is exactly the same of the, like the person who thinks they know better when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, listen, this is the prescription, this is the iddah. And we think that no, that was a tale of a long time ago. So we will bash into other motor vehicles and it will result in our own death or in the destruction of our own bodies. May Allah not do that to us. You know, when it comes to a motor vehicle, it's very easy for us to understand because we know we'll be hurt. But when it comes to the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it becomes difficult, doesn't it? Why? Because unfortunately we need to build on our iman because it has become weak sometimes. May Allah grant us benefit of the month of Ramadan. This is why He gives us the month of Ramadan. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the rights of husband and wife and the fact that each one has rights similar to those rights that they themselves have to fulfill. So the husband can't come and say, you know my right. And the wife can't come and say, you know my right. Because they both have rights. You know our rights. You have rights, I have rights. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if we fulfill those rights correctly, then the male is granted one step higher than the female, obviously, because he is the husband, he is supposed to be the breadwinner, and he is supposed to be fulfilling so many roles. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to fulfill our roles and not to think that those roles are the roles that we eat from the bakery. Because a lot of the people, unfortunately, now they've swapped roles and they don't understand. So when you tell them, have you fulfilled your role? They tell you, you know what, I've even eaten it. May Allah protect us all. May Allah grant us understanding. So each one needs to fulfill his or her role. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that makes mention of Ayatul Kursi. Very briefly, it is a solid verse. A very solid verse. I'm sure we all know it by heart. It has protection in it. One day Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu caught Shaytan. And he was about to strangle Shaytan. And Shaytan tells him, you know what? I can teach you something which will give you protection from me and my progeny. So Abu Huraira said, all right, in that case I will leave you. And Shaytan taught Abu Hurairah Ayatul Kursi. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu left Shaytan and went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, you know what, I was taught these verses by Shaytan. Because obviously Shaytan must have heard the verses when they were being revealed. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Sadaqaka wa huwa kadhubun. Watch out, be careful, he's a very big liar. But in this case, he told you the truth. He's a very big liar, but in this case he told you the truth. Amazing. That means Ayatul Kursi will protect us from Shaytan. May we be granted the ability to read it every morning and evening for protection. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then speaks about spending wealth in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says, وَأَنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Spend in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So many verses speak about spending in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But do you know what? These verses are different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَىٰ. O you who believe, understand and realize that you can spoil the reward of your charities. By doing what? By bragging about it. The minute you brag about a charity that you have spent, you lose the reward of it. And Allah says, the minute you harm people because you feel that you are the one who is wealthy and you are the one who controls everything because people depend on that wealth of yours, the minute that type of attitude comes in us, Allah says, you've already spoilt the entire charity. So these verses are very important. All of us give out a little bit of charity. Even those who cannot afford, give out 1 rand, 2 rand, 5 rands. Wallahi, it is an act of worship that will cleanse our hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, but once you give, don't think you did anyone a favor. They did you a favor by accepting that wealth. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not want it, He would have used someone else in the same cause. And it has happened so many times where people come across and they say, I will not spend in this cause anymore, not realizing that instead of them fixing those people, Allah is fixing them, because Allah does not want them to use their wealth in such a cause. May Allah protect us. It is very, very deep. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us about interest and the fact that we should not be eating interest. I want to mention just one verse. Allah says, فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا فَأَذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. If you are not going to leave interest and the eating of interest and the dealing in interest and so on, Allah says, war is being announced against you by Allah and His Messenger. Today, if the army of any country had to announce war against me or you or my community, we would be the first to run away because we know what would happen. Not the armies of any countries, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, the creator of the universe, is telling us, be careful, don't cheat, don't deceive when it comes to sustenance, earn a halal sustenance, be happy, and Allah will grant you happiness in your progeny as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that to us. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah, most